everyone. Welcome to Daimler Truck Asia's Design Center in Kawasaki, Japan. I'm Carrie, and today we're here with Varruna. And Varruna has designed a concept vehicle called Primal, and we'll be talking about it today. Welcome, Varruna.
Hi. Hi, guys.
First of all, Varruna, why don't you tell everybody who you are and what you do at FUSO?
My name is Varun. I come from a very small town called as Mudigere, which is in the southern part of India. I'm currently doing my master's in transportation and automobile design from National Institute of Design, Ahmedabad. I'm currently working as a creative design intern at the Design Center in Advanced Design, Mitsubishi FUSO, Daimler Truck Asia.
Now, let's talk a little bit about the main reason we're here today. Tell us about your project, Primal.
Project Primal was envisioned a year back in order to design a tool that can be used by overlanding truckers. So we have seen already our current Cater chassis being used all over Europe and Japan for overlanding purposes. We wanted to show these kind of truckers that what your lifestyle can be. And we at FUSO are very reliable on sustainable transportation systems, and we are working towards it. So we wanted to show how they can adopt to sustainable transportation solutions, and also in turn help them explore nature and connect back to nature.
Okay, I just step back a bit. Are you into overlanding yourself?
Yeah, so I come from a place which is more of a hill station. So I am very lucky that my friends, my family often go out on overlanding vacations. More ideas came in when I talked to people who already are into overlanding experiences. I talked to Ryan, who was one of the members who designed the Pro Canter, and also Ronnie and Barty, who is also a YouTuber, YouTube channel. They also go on overlanding trips, and they wanted something that they wanted to open up to nature. So that was the whole theme of the project, where you can use this vehicle to elevate to nature.
And when I had the VR experience earlier, all around, when you're inside the vehicle, around you can see outside. It's very open.
So this is a center driving system that we wanted to have to see the possibility of it. Because you're in an overlanding experience, you can see almost 180 degree field of view. So that is what you come out for. You want to see the nature, you want to see the outsides. So this is designed for 2035, where it is all, you can now yourself relate how the current cities are. It's basically a concrete jungle, and you're like digitally overloaded with all the products. So you want to break free from that environment and go out to nature, connect back to nature.
And I mean, perhaps I'm not one of the original customers you had in mind, but having experienced it, I think it really fills those, those requirements.
Because we try to address all those persona using CMF. So we had three types of personas. So one was a more extrovert persona who was more into adventure sports, who was more into showing off. The second persona is a more introvert persona who is much in line with nature, who is much subtle, very introvert in nature, but also wants to experience nature to its fullest. And the third persona is a much of an influencer persona who sees these two persona and try to influence using his social media networks or any other networks to influence others to get into overlanding. So based on that, we wanted to see how sustainability can play a role in terms of color, material and finish. So me and Sneha worked on trying to relate what color can bring out specific emotions. So that was the whole working style that we did for CMF.
Thank you so much, and thank you for dropping in there that CMF is color, material, finish. And these are important considerations in the design process.
For this project and for all the design projects, CMF is very important in order to prove the concept to the customers. So because at the end of the day, when the customers are using the product, they need to relate to the product, they need to use the product. So it comes from all the color, the finish, the textures that you have in the vehicle. CMF was all around being like a backbone of the whole project, where every point, every sketch was influenced by the CMF part of it. So as you can see, there was a CMF board set up for people to touch and feel things in order to understand what it is to mean to touch, feel, and get a sense of what products that they use. So we took the inspiration of the products that is currently being used by the customers in terms of adventure sports, in terms of camping, in terms of influencing, and we took those as an inspiration. We also got sustainable materials from our own suppliers in order to explore what all future possibilities are there in terms of using sustainable materials to make FUSO more sustainable in the future.
Yeah. And obviously CMF is just one part of the process, and it was just one part of this project.
Yeah.
So I imagine you worked with a number of other people in a number of different areas.
Yeah.
How did you manage all of that? Talk to us about that.
I was very lucky to have a good and a great team who supported and who believed in the idea that I had, and also contributed their ideas, their time in order to support this project. So in terms of sketching, while we were sketching, I still remember Diego helping me out what kind of concept we want to build, and repeated reviews we had in middle of working projects. Even we collaborated with DICV India Studio, and me, Abhishek, and Vivakaran would work on the 3D model to see the possibility of the vehicle and how we could realize that in Unreal Engine and make cool renders out of it.
Oh, thank you. And this is
the
prototype here. And I do have to say I experienced a few surprises when I touched it.
Yeah.
But so I imagine some of the materials you gathered, or all of the materials you put into the prototype here.
So the main inspiration to design this vehicle was the carabiner tool that people in rock climbing or adventure sports use. So as you can see that you have to make your own bed. When you climb to the vehicle, you have to climb like a rock climber. So rock climbing harnesses comes out of the vehicle. So this is just a tool for people to understand what it is to be in nature.
So you said that in the design process, you also incorporated some Japanese elements. Could you talk a bit about that?
Yeah, so Shinrin Yoku was one such element which meant forest bathing. The tradition is that people go out in nature, immerse themselves in nature in order to experience nature. And that is one of the traditions in Japan. So I was like literally amazed to see the tradition currently being lost in Japan. So we wanted to bring all those elements back into the vehicle. We at FUSO also emphasis on the heritage part of everything. So we wanted to show that as well for the Japanese audience.
Yeah. And when we're looking at some of the CMF kind of inspiration, some of the materials, we also came upon some Japanese linen and some indigo. Could you talk a little bit about
that? So we went to thrift markets in order to see what kind of fabrics the Japanese use. So we tried to get inspiration from those samples. And one such workshop that I attended was an indigo dyeing workshop. Indigo is one of such color which was heavily influenced in Japanese culture in terms of samurai clothing, in terms of royal clothing. So it is considered to be very sacred also. We tried to inculcate that colors into the vehicle in the breeze variant, where we could explore those palettes and we could explore how it can be related to the Japanese audience also.
Wow, so as we can see, there's quite a lot that goes into designing anything. Quite a lot has gone into designing this Primal here. So what after Primal? What comes next for you?
Probably, as I said, a 1:1 scale model to prove the concept.
Mm.
But yeah, nevertheless, there are still many things that I need to work on this project in terms of the proof of concept. But yeah, it still is an exciting way ahead to work upon.
And what would you say has been perhaps the most important learning for you in working on this project?
I think for me, the most important thing that I learned was people skills. I think here in Daimler Truck Asia, we have a lot of diverse demography. We have people from Germany, we have people from Japan, India, Brazil,
Jamaica.
And like we could interact with all those people and I could get different philosophies from them. That was the major learning for me. Also the support that I got from my department in terms of believing in this idea, believing in me in execution. Supporting me all the way through. It was more of a humbling experience and a lot of learning in terms of that, yeah.
Wow, thank you so much. Right, so as you can see, quite a lot goes into a truck and a lot has gone into this truck, Primal. Thank you so much for joining us here at Daimler Truck Asia's Design Center, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.